Ciao a tutti! Welcome to another video! Today we are gonna do another art journal project and I want to use some of those thin paper that usually we found on a shoebox or like when ordering clothes. And I'm gonna prepare my tissue paper adding some stamp randomly here and there. I'm just using two stamp sets that I had in my stage, a travel set and a background set and some random letters here and there. Then I'm using Memento ink. That's important because otherwise if you use a different ink it's gonna smear. And then I'm just cut with my hands and put randomly on a page, and I'm using matte medium gel as well to glue everything down. So I'm just putting there randomly on the page just to start a background. I'm gonna have the process that I made to prepare the tissue paper on a short video, but I didn't want to get this video too long, so I just cut it out. And as you can see, using the matte medium, everything is gonna stay in place, no smear, nothing, because I used the Memento ink before. That's really important because otherwise it's gonna be a mess, really, trust me. I want to say that for this project I started in one way, but then while I was creating I had in the end another thing in mind, so I really changed my mind on this video. You will see kind of two or three times, so you can even use one of the three process that I did to make different pages basically than mine. Because I started with this background and I thought it was pretty nice, but then I didn't know what to put on top, so I decided to try another technique on top of this one, and you will see in a bit I am gonna try the technique using the ink pad. It's Ranger Oxide ink, and I'm just with the ink pad itself I'm just putting the ink into an oven paper, and then I'm spraying some water on it and to make it a kind of watercolor, and then I'm gonna print basically with the oven paper onto the page. In this way the look is really subtle and you will have some kind of drops here and there, so it's a nice look. But then with the focal point I had some difficulty with that look, so then I changed my mind again. But this is something that for sure I want to use in a different in a new page. Just that look, it's nice, I like it, it's random. And you can even again put some more water on there and add again on the page a different color. And it's important to have a dry page here and time to time, and then add again other ink. Then after doing that one and having everything dry, I thought that I had too much space in between of the tissue paper, so I added another color as a base color on top of that tissue paper basically, and so I'm just covering all of it, and it gave a sad look. And I'm mixing with orange and some blue. I'll put all the colors that I'm using in the video itself, so you can follow me and you can do exactly the same look if you like on your page as well. So after doing that, I decided to have also a darker border, and so I'm gonna go with the same with a darker color that I have all around the page. But then in the end it was still too present, the stamp that I had in the tissue paper was still too present, so in the end I decided to add some white color on top. But instead I could have used just gesso, but in the end I decided to use just my water my white acrylic paint, but I add some water to have a bit more less heavy on the page. And I'm just covering, in the beginning I was thinking to cover just a piece of that, but in the end I decided to cover all of them, all the page. Now for the focal point I decided to have some hot air balloon, and I'm just doing on a normal page, print page, so not an heavy one. That's what I had, and I'm using some watercolor to color it, and I'm just design the look that I want for the hotel balloon. I will have three, one big, another medium, and one small, with different look, and I will use a rainbow color in the three of them. I have speeded up this part, it's times four basically, to avoid to have it the video too long again, but if you want to, you can even skip the coloring part, and you can jump on minutes 9.5 to see how in the end I assembled everything on the page and complete basically the page. I leave you now with some music in the meanwhile, while coloring, and I'll see you in a bit. I'm back, and so finally on the focal point I decided to, I like to add some detail with some pen or marker, because in the end it make my life a lot easier, because I'm not good to add detail with a brush. And in this case I'm using my colorful gel pen with some glitter and matching with the color that I had in the background of the focal point. At the end, I'm just cutting out everything, all the images with my scissor, and then I try to finish the background. At this point, I realized that a blue background would have been much better. So in the end, I'm coloring everything back with the blue that I had, the blue ink that I had in my stash. It was strange, to be honest. When I added the ink on top of the acrylic paint, the white acrylic paint, the ink was so moving so much in the page, and the result was a bit too light than expected, but okay, it was a last minute thought, so next time I won't do it, to be honest, but it's fine. After gluing the focal point down and cut the excess, I decided to add a border on the page. I'm just using some white acrylic, and then on top of that, I will use some black acrylic paint. I want to make sure that all the strokes are very visible. This is the look that I really like. So I'm using a dry brush and I'm putting, even with the white and with the black, I'm using just a dry brush. Really, on this page, I changed the idea so many times that we cannot even see anymore the tissue, all the tissue paper that I have underneath. So it's really light look there. But I'm gonna use that technique on another video for sure. Now, at this point, it's time for the quote. I started with a thin black marker, and then I added a big brush marker to highlight the letters that I have over there. And the quote of today says, "The higher we soar, the smaller we appear to those who cannot fly." I really like that one. I always find a quote looking at Pinterest. That's I think it's the best place to find something that inspires you. Then I had to be careful, to be honest, to don't touch the background with my hand while writing down the quote, since the blue ink, as I was saying, was still kind of wet, so I didn't want to smear anything. So I've used a piece of paper to cover the background while I was writing my quote. And finally, as a finished touch, I added some highlights with my white Posca pen. That's something that I always like to do. And that's it, basically, that's the page. I will add some close-up picture in the end of the video, and I hope that you liked it and had so much fun experimenting with new technique with me. I really had. Are you trying any new technique? Just let me know, leave me a comment. I'm always enjoying to see what others are doing. It's always nice to be inspired by you. I mean, that's the best thing, I think, on YouTube. I think that everybody can inspire each other. I really like. Anyway, that's it for today. Thanks a lot for watching, and see you soon for next video. Bye bye.